Greetings, everyone, and welcome to the next episode of Infinity. How are you? New year. Oh, sticky keys. Oh, the love of... Oh, what's the point of sticky keys? I mean, I ask you. No, go away. So that's a good start, isn't it? Good start, new year, and, you know, that's the start we have. But the reason I'm drawing your attention over here is we have this little list here. We ran out of things to do last time, so I thought I'd set out some new tasks. And as you can see, garden subnet is the first on the area, farm area, which I'll show you out later. Tree farm is also part of a garden subnet. Actually, it's not. I tell a lie. The garden subnet is just mainly for seeds and things, and anything that we harvest from the farms. The tree farm, which is out behind me, will be hooked up to our ME system, which I have moved. So let's get on, and I will show you the updates that we've made. I've now covered this big reactor over here with a glass floor. I don't know, it's just, I'm not quite sure about this room. Not quite sure what to do with it. Maybe that was too low, maybe that needs to be higher. I mean, we can always raise it up. But I did find a nice little place for the QED. Just in the roof there. It's a nice little effect, I think. It kind of melds in well with these technical blocks. There's still areas to open here and here. And down there as well. There's still things to do with these sections here. But hey. Right now, let's look at getting the garden all sorted. Now, one thing, I don't know what I'm pressing here. One thing I will show you before we get to the garden, actually. Let's get myself in order. I've sorted out this area a little bit better. It was a bit of a mess. This is where the AE system was before. Let me just scooch up here and I'll show you. The AE system was just tucked in here. I thought I'd leave this open. I'm going to fill this in eventually, but for the purposes of this video, I thought I'd leave that open. Just to show you where it was. It's now further down, underground, but yeah. So I tidied this all up. We now have two sets of spawners. This one needs some more in it, but we've got witches in there, hiding in the background. A couple of fans at the back, blows them forward, and all the drops and stuff go down underground. Yeah. Most of them get dumped into this chest over here. You can still see all the piping and things. This is really a bit of a mess on this side at the moment. I'm still trying to organise the piping. What I've got down here is I've got a double system where all the essence from both of these spawners comes down into these drums. From these drums, it then gets filtered across, out, and up into... that's the other one. This is the one it gets funneled up into, but I can't get in because the fans are always blowing me. There you go. And that goes into the auto spawner, which is actually spawning Enderman at the moment. As you can see, that's full, but it doesn't take much to catch up. As you can see, these barrels are constantly filling and emptying and filling. There you go. Filling and emptying. So even though we've got four spawners on the go up there, still not quite enough for these fellas. Yeah, so I might need to expand this one a little bit. I didn't want to do that. Put that back. What have we got in here? I think we've got just Blaze in there. May have got Blaze and Witches, not quite sure. Can't quite see. Yeah, Blaze and Witches, that is. And they all fuel this fella. Now this is where I've been getting Wither Skulls from. Gas tears and all sorts, as this little clip will tell you. Spawns galore. I've sat AFK for a while and let this this run. Still not. Why is that grinder not going down quick enough? I think there may be. Oops, sneak peek. I think there may be an issue here. Because this is one pipeline and it's coming from this. I'm wondering if that is not being able to empty properly. So we may be losing some there. I might have to put a loop in. Or maybe just run this way and then bring it straight in. Disconnect that grinder from this spawner so that that grinder also goes into these buckets and then ferries back around there. In fact, let's do that now. Why the heck not? It's a little bit impromptu, wasn't on our list, but I've just seen this problem and thought this might be a wise thing to sort out. So let's pop these. Let's give it some space. Let's come across here and then there and there and there. Bada 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 bing. Pop them across. You're going to have to move. And let's just pop the torch in there instead. Put two of them in. And then to make these work, when you've got an empty one and a full one, it doesn't class them as the same object. So what you need is your little Yetta wrench. This fella. And this is the recipe of you need to make it, electrical steel. And a basic gear. And what you do is you right click on either end, either this section here or this section here, and it will connect them up. And voila, like that. So that's now funneling all the way down here. So if I get in here and then I right click that, that'll connect there. And then, oof, this fan keeps blowing me away. Then I want to disconnect that completely, like that. And then we'll have that one and that one and that one and that one. And now that should... No, that needs to... Yeah, that needs to go into there, doesn't it? So this needs to come out, this one. And then we just open that one. That should now empty this up here. Let's just have a look. Yeah, that grinder's now empty. So that means... these are full-ish, but I wouldn't say that they're brilliantly full. Let's just pop upstairs and have a looky-loo what's going on. Which one was it? Was it this fella? Yeah, this was the grinder that was full. So all grinders are now empty. Marvellous. Nice cheese hat, sir. Nice cheese hat. Everybody loves a cheese hat. So, back downstairs. And here we are. This is the new AE system. All bedecked in our technical blocks. Little glowstones, little fancy lanterns, you know, receded into it. But it breaks it up nicely. A couple of different types. We've got the sturdy technical and the great. I think the great looks kind of great, really. Yeah. Wordplay. So we're going to this room. And I'm just starting to do a little bit of decoration. There is going to be some things in here when we get round to it. I think I might move all these crafting elements into this room here and have one big crafting grid in there. I mean, this is fine at the moment. It's the bee's knees doing the job. I kind of like this little... It's very compact for what it is. To say we've got 12 ME drives... we've got some chests and controllers and this whole nine yards. We've even got the security terminal, the IO port. We've got a bin up there as well. Then we've got energy acceptors. And then right underneath here, we have an ender chest. And what this does is anything coming in like that pops in to this ME interface, which then pops it into the system down here. And yeah, managed to get one big storage there. You can get more than that, and I am aiming to up the storage so I can get pretty much the top tier of these ME storages. Let's have a look what top tier will be. Storage. And we're looking at, well, that'd be the big one. 16,000. 16384. And obviously these, like the rest of the storage, takes quite a lot of work to get where it's going, all the way down to this. But now we've got auto crafting, it shouldn't be such a problem. But that's a long way away. I'm slowly filling them up with the 64Ks, which should be more than enough for what we're going to do. Although, you know me, I will probably set up some deep storage for persistent things like... for some reason when I said persistent, I meant persistent like that. For persistent storage like cobble, dirt, things like that. Let me just have a glug on this juice. That's some fine fruit in that juice. Excuse me. So yes, this is now the ME system. Let's toggle that up. As you can see, we're close to a million stone, 72,000 cobble. So it's quite horrific, the amount of stuff going in here. I've got stuff auto pulverizing as well, and I'll take you upstairs and show you that. As you can see, we have this little power point here, and nothing else. Everything is done by ender chests. So let's just pop back upstairs. Let me just pop that back in there. Let's pop back. Where am I going? Up here. There we go. So this hasn't changed. This is still the same. Yummy berries. Let's have them. Why the heck not? Nom nom nom. And I'll just pop that in here. Keep all my XP in this fella. This experience obelisk, so I can pull it out when I need to, when I'm enchanting things. So we don't use these anymore, these modular storages. I mean, I know it's still got bits and pieces in it, and this has still got loads of stuff in it. But eventually I'll be moving these out. And now I've connected these to, look at this, some dense cable. We've got some P2P tunnels downstairs, working their way up to each side. So we've got 10 on this side, 10 on that side. So 10 sag mills and 10 furnaces. Beavering away and then sending the contents all the way back downstairs. So let me show you downstairs. This is the underdwelling. I just basically dug straight down, found out where the ME system was. Oh, actually, I think it's this way, isn't it? Yeah, down here. So I stuck in a little elevator. You may be lost. I shall show you where we are. If I can just get on that pad properly. There you go. Let me turn hover off. So we're just one down. I say one down, we're about three or four down from the ME system, so directly underneath it. So we're running these two colours, as I've said before, and they're coming from, I'll just take you around this corner, and they're coming from underneath of our ME system, which is up there. I've yet to organise this better because I'm not really using it as well as I could. Obviously, I'm going to need some more dense cables coming off here. This is just a power link. As you can see, I've got a little bit of quartz fiber there. I'll probably put that over this side so we're not impinging on the space that we can use for the ME controllers. But that's, again, down the line once we expand a little bit more. So this is the ugly piece down here. This is where I've been caving and things. And yes, there's still things in the wall. Yes, I know. I know. I'll clean them up eventually. So, what was we going to do? Right, we were going to look at a garden subnet, weren't we? I'll take you outside. We'll have a look at the garden. And now, once we do that, we'll be right back. Ah, what a glorious day. Another glorious day. My tree farm is stuck, and the reason my tree farm is stuck is because it is full, absolutely chock full. So I need to sort this out. I mean, I know we run out of lava in that one, but I do have a bedrockium drum, and there were lots and lots and lots. That should be on extract, actually. Let's do that. So that should pump into there. There we go. And that'll fill this back up. But the tree farm's working really nicely. I've got jungle saplings on the go at the moment. And underneath here, I popped in some nether wart. I've just been growing some 10 10 10 nether wart down there. One thing we need to worry about is that we don't bump into the sludge system down there when we dig through for our subnet for this. But while the squiddies are here, I shall have you. If I can stay still long enough. There we go, that's one. Get wrecked. So nothing much is done since last time on this side. All I'm trying to do really is I'm expanding the farm in this direction. We now have the little chickens and the sheepies up here. They are kind of in the way because I want the farm to go this way. Let's just throw things back in the system. We don't need that, don't need that, that, or that. All that will look good actually. All that exact. Look at me go. So yeah, I kind of want the farms to expand in this general direction, but probably not in this one line. I don't like the idea that it's just a straight cut like that. I want it to have some definition, some curvature and things. So that's to do. So we've to move these fellas at some point, but that's no great shakes, we can do that. So down here, I've been working on the flower seeds for Botania, or another one of those magic mods. Because I know these are going to be necessary later on, and we need the dyes as well, so I've been working on these. These are all 10-10-10s, apart from you for some reason. You're 8-8. How very bizarre. Why are you 8-8? I'm positive you was 8-10. Sorry, 10-10-10. Anyway. That's how Northerners say something's not in the box. Tin, tin, tin. There you go. Comedy. Yeah. So also up here, we've been working on things that can't be podzle. I mean, this is podzle because that's what they grow on. But the tulips and things only grow on dirt. And this is done by zombies stepping off this ledge, trampling my farmland. So again, we've got 10, 10, 10s on these. I just did these the other day. I'll be going through. I want to kind of go through all of them. That's one thing I've never done. I've only just stuck with the colours that I want. But I think it'd be nice to get all of them going in here. We've even got some daisies and tulips on this side. It's all very good. We've also extended the river around a little bit as well. I want to carry that on in that direction. Might have some kind of waterfall coming down here. But the garden's going to hopefully spiral round. Follow this contour a bit more with the sheep pens and hen pens up there. That's the idea anyway. And this is just my little breeding system. You've seen this before. Well, the way I do this. In fact, let me just do this because these are eights. So let me just pop that in there. And then what I'm going to do is I've got a green bag of holding, which is my gardening bag of holding. And in there we've got the watering can and the sticks we need and the clippers. So let's just pop them like that. Let's just swap them round. And so we can grow this one nice and quickly. I'll speed this up. Like that, so we get a mature. Take a clipping or two off it. And where's the clippings gone? There they are. Oh, I've just noticed I've got some squid in here. Oh, raw calamari. Lovely. Lovely stuff. So we pop the clipping down there and one down there. And then we water all three of those. Again, I'll speed this up. Like that. There you go. So we have 3 10-10-8. So what I do, I mean, I may be doing this wrong, but this works for me. I pop this in the middle. Now, because they're all clippings of the same seed, we should get a higher value than this in there. So let's just try that. And all you have to do is just literally grow it like that. You don't have to grow it fully. Just grow it like that. Pick it up. Where's my seed analyzer gone? It's because I'm working up here. Let's pop this unidentified one in here. It'll probably be 10-10-9. Yeah, 10-10-9. So let's try and get a 10-10. Whoa! hovers on. Turn hover off. Try get another one. I mean, don't always settle for the first one. You could actually get better seeds just if you keep trying. There you go, let's take that one, have a look-see. And where are we? There we are. Hopefully we get 10-10-10. And no, 10-10-9. So you just keep trying until you do get a 10-10-10. Or if you want and you don't want to hang around and you want to speed this up a little bit more, you can always plant 10-10-9 and plant it exactly the way we've just done there, and you'll definitely get a 10-10-10 out of it. We've got another 10-10-9. So I've got three 10-10-9s now anyway. So let's just pop this down. I'm kind of detracting from what I was going to do today, but you know, it's horses for courses, isn't it? We've got loads of things we need to achieve. So let's do this. These are probably not going to grow very well because they're not... Well, I don't know actually. I've never actually tried it. I've always gone for the clipping route. Now I know you can interbreed with these. That's how you get the different types. But I've never tried this way before. So this is new for you. It's new for me. So let's give this a go. 10-10-10. Straight away. Straight off the bat. Give me that. Give me the money. Show me the money. There you go. And 10-10-10. There you go. Straight away. First time. Hell yeah. So we come down here. Let's get rid of that. That pretender. We don't want that now. And then pop that in there. The only problem with being here with my magnet on is I keep getting eggs, which is always fun. We can drop that in the system now. So I'm just going to water this one up like this, and this is how you expand these. Now you could expand it by just putting in a breeding section, a cross planting sticks there, but there's no need, because if you did that and you harvest this, it would be undefined. You'd have to keep going over here to get it defined. So if you take a clipping off a 10-10-10 and plant it there, as you can see in the wheelier at the top, it becomes 10-10-10 automatically. So you don't have to do anything. And then you'll get four, I think it's four seeds off each or something like that. Anywho, so what are these? These are 10-10-9s. So let's get rid of these. We don't want that muck anymore. Let's get rid of that. So you can go and you can go. And all is well with the world. Throw them away. So let's pop these in there like that. You can see this is my little gardening bag. This is how I've been doing the tulips. Because you can find out each tulip has, each seed has a crossbreed. So if you just go into the uses of that seed, it'll show you the crop mutations you can have. So a yellow and red makes a blue. And that's how you can see the natural progression that I've gone on. So we've got yellow daisy makes white tulip. As you can see over here, we had the daisies and the white tulips. And that was the last one I worked on from yellow, I believe. Let's have a look. Did that one. We've got the pink tulip. Got that one. We've got the daisy seeds, which we've got from the blue orchids. Mystical yellow flower seeds. We already have those down here. And that's all we need for the yellow one. So the yellow one can go away now. But yeah. So that's a quick insight on how to grow these seeds. But I'm getting distracted. So here we are in the kitchen, eh? So let me just put this back to the right view. I've already picked out some bits and pieces that we need to make a nice separate subnetwork. And let's just pop these down here. By subnetwork, I mean it's not going to be connected to the main network. Inside the house. This is going to be its own separate network out here, simply so I can work on the plants. So all the foodstuffs will be in here, all the seeds will be in here, and that's the idea. So let me just dig out a little... Are we going to put it in the corner? We're going to put it in the corner. Yeah, why not? Let's do it. Yes, I am breaking wood with axe. I'm a fool, the boy's a fool. Let's just dig that out. pop the energy cell down there. The ME drive, I'm... no. Ooh, that's going to be a point. I need to see the energy drive. Sorry, the ME drive. Whoop. The ME drive. And the reason is, if I can't see it, I can't put storage into it. So, that's the end of that. And I thought, you know, green, you know, guard thing. And that becomes green. Well, you see. Apart from this is an ME terminal, and not a crafting window. That's an error. That's a boob. So let's get rid of that. And then in here, we're going to pop in a 63k storage. So let me get this wired up, and we'll get a proper crafting terminal on the top of there. And that'll probably be it for this episode. So I'll crack on with this, and then you'll see the fruits of my labour next episode. So thank you very much for stopping by and having a watch today. It's always appreciated, and I hope you enjoyed it as much as I do. So I will love you and leave you. I shall see you on the flip side, and as always, much love. Much love.